I've got some of my inlay in there. It's looking gorgeous. So that's the procedure there. And then I think I'm gonna turn it around and fill the knot and do some of my lines. As you get it, the less you have to sand down, so that's why I'm being so meticulous with it. Again, doesn't have to be perfect because I think the ruggedness of it looks really cool, makes it look a little more rustic. Let's do a little bit more up here. Cool. Just fill up that top area because I'm going to leave a little area to put my clasp at the top. Maybe a little bit more like right there. Yeah, that's good. So once you get your piece all glued in there, kind of have to let this set for, I like to let mine set for a good 24 hours just so it sets up. bit more right here. Yeah, that looks really cool. Okay, I might go ahead and just do this larger groove here. I don't want to do all of the lines. I like the look of the wood there, so maybe just one more coming down right here. Just a little bit, and looks like it's kind of flowing down into the wood a little bit. Very cool. This little knot too right here. Won't be much, but I thought that would be cute. Just that little tiny hole there. See how unique this stuff is? Like, there's never gonna be another piece like it anywhere. So that's what I'm loving about it. Yeah, that's cool. Maybe a little more right here, and then I promise I'm done. Cool. Grab my little what it needed. Very artistic. All right, so that one's ready to sit and set. Like I said, I'll leave it probably 24 hours and then I'll go in and fine tune it, make it look cleaner, polish it, put a little resin on, and it's ready to put a clasp. I'll probably flatten this part out so that I can put a round clasp in there, and we use all sterling silver for our clasp.